Okay, for question 8, anyone has any problem with question 8? Okay, let's go through question 8. So you have a table with 3 columns and it's filled with numbers in a certain pattern. We can see a pattern. So it's 1, 2, 3. Then you turn the other way around, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12. So you know that they are in multiples of 3, right? 3, 6, 9, 12. Am I right or wrong? Okay, they are in multiples of 3. And then when it's a odd number, you'll be in column C. Even number is at column A, correct or wrong? Okay, can you see? 3, 6, 9, 12. Okay, now let's look at 306. We know that we are looking at multiples of 3. So 306, I divide by 3, and I'll get 102. That means that row 102, correct or wrong? But how do I know is it column A or column C? Okay, how do I know whether is that column A or column C? Very simple, right? Because we know that if 306 is an even number, it will be at column A. If it's not, then you'll be at column C, like, sorry? 10 is it a multiple of 3? 10 is it a multiple of 3? I say again, it must be a multiple of 3. For example, 3, 6, 9, 12. But from here, you can see that if it's an even number, you will be at column A. If it's an odd number, you'll be at column C. Can you see? 306, is it even or odd number? Even, right? So we know the row number, we also know the column, right? So it's column A. Anyone has any problem? Okay, so the answer is column A. Okay, quite easy. This is a pattern question. Next, question 9. Anyone has any problem? Question 9. Okay, let's go through question 9. In the diagram below, A, C, E, G, and B, D, F, H are squares. Where are the two squares? Let me highlight for you. A, C, E, G. This is the first square. And I have B, D, F, H is another square. What we know is that A, B, C, D, okay, which are the lengths that are equal? A, B, C, D, EF and GH, they are equal length. Correct? If these four lengths are equal, am I right to conclude that these four lengths are equal as well? Since it's a square, right? Correct? So since these four lengths are four identical triangles, right? Do I have four identical triangles? 1, 2, 3, 4. Do you see 4 identical triangles? Okay. So the ratio of AB to BC is 3 is to 2. AB is 3. This is 2, right? 3 units, 2 units. Correct or wrong? Okay. Or we can just treat it as 3cm or 2cm. Also can. 3 is to 2. Just treat it as 3 is to 2. If here is 3, here is 2. Then here must be 2, here must be 3, right? Yeah. Okay. Now, if I'm treating this as 5 units, this whole thing, AC, correct? Yeah. The whole triangle will be 25 units, right? Yes. Unit square, 25 unit square, yes or no? Yeah. Because 5 times 5. Okay? Right, the big square is 5 times 5, right? 25 units square. Okay, so area of ACEG will be 5 unit times 5 unit, 25 unit square, right? Okay. So, next, what fraction of the square ACEG is shaded? I need to find the area of one triangle, right? Yes or no? Okay. If you find the units confusing, it's fine. You don't write units, okay? Can? You find the unit square confusing, you can choose not to write. Okay, let's say I don't write it. Now next, how to find area? Give me a formula, Kaden. Half times 3 times 2, right? Half times base times height. And that'll give me 3, right? And since I got 4 triangles, area of 4 triangles will be 3 multiplied by 4 equals to 12, right? Yes or no? So you know that the 4 triangles are unshaded, am I right? Okay, so they want to find what fraction is shaded. 25 minus 12 equals to 13. So 13 over the whole thing. Is this the simplest form? Okay, so we know that this is the answer. Anyone has any problem? Okay. Good. Daryl? And one more person just now, I couldn't remember. One more person raised their hand here. You understand? Okay, let's look at question 10. Anyone has any problem with question 10? One? The rest is okay? Kaden, can you help him with question 10 later? Okay, we'll stop here for today. I'm going to give you a homework.